Tesla plans to expand Model Y production lines at its Fremont factory in Northern California. Filings submitted to the city of Fremont reveal. Excessive demand for cars is a problem that most, if not all, car manufacturers would like to have, especially after we have all gone through crazy years. Tesla seems unable to keep up with the demand for its vehicles, especially the Model Y crossover, so it is time to expand Fremont again. Elon Musk has asked employees to go super hardcore to make up for production challenges early in the third quarter and ensure a decent Q3 delivery number. Musk also gave new updates on the full self-driving version 10, saying that FSD 10 will blow your mind. Although Tesla's Berlin Gigafactory has begun to lay the foundation for the world's largest battery factory, which plans to produce the 4,680 cells, a recent video from the Shanghai Gigafactory shows that with the arrival of the third quarter of 2021, Special Slug China is ready for another quarter-end push to the end. Finally, if you are buying an electric car, then you are likely to follow the Tesla Model 3 or Model Y. So how do you choose between these two compelling Tesla models? Let's review all the details. Before we start, if you like this video, please don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe to Technopole, and click the bell button to get notifications. Model Y is Tesla's latest car and the company's most popular car in multiple markets including the United States. The all-electric crossover is produced on the production line at the Fremont plant in Northern California, called General Assembly 4.5, and has been in production since February 2020. Tesla installed the GA 4.5 production line outside the main facility of the Fremont plant. Since February 2020, this is also part of the Model 3 production base. In February of this year, Tesla formally submitted an application to the city of Fremont to make the spring structure permanent and add 64,000 square feet of expansion area to the factory. In July, Tesla officially began making GA 4.5 a permanent part of the company's production facilities, adding underground sewer connections for pipelines and creating foundation work for spring structures. Now that the GA 4.5 production line has been permanently installed in the factory, it seems that Tesla is trying to specifically expand the production capacity of these production lines. New documents from the city of Fremont show that Tesla has applied for the 4.5 expansion, as well as several other documents, including the GA 4.5 South expansion shell. Elon Musk asked employees to become super hardcore to ensure the number of deliveries in the third quarter. The CEO said that the wave of deliveries at the end of the quarter was unusually high. Earlier this quarter, Tesla suffered an extremely serious shortage of parts and components like the entire industry. This is the biggest wave in Tesla history, Musk said, referring to its end-of-quarter delivery push, and Tesla built a lot of cars with missing parts that needed to be added later. The CEO also provided new updates on fully autonomous version 10 and how the automaker plans to expand its FSD beta test group. The beta program was launched in late 2020 and gave a small number of Tesla drivers the opportunity to experience Tesla's most robust FSD software yet. Since then, as the semi-autonomous driving software has been improved through software updates, Tesla has expanded the test group to generate more data. On September 1, Musk said that FSD Beta 10 will be released on Friday, September 10, and a public request button will be released 2 weeks later. This button will allow drivers using the Tesla FSD kit to opt into the beta program. After saying that FSD 9.2 is not very good, Musk finally clarified how good the new beta version is for drivers. Musk said FSD 10 will surprise you. Over the course of the past 9 months, Tesla has made so many improvements in its fully automated driving tasks, increased the accuracy of the kit's performance, and added new driving behaviors to the features of each version. The drivers have always been honest and frank about the improvements Tesla can make. The automaker listened to opinions and tried to improve it as soon as possible to achieve level 5 autonomous driving so that the vehicle can drive autonomously. On the occasion of Tesla's last battery day in September last year, two announcements caught people's attention. The suggestion that Tesla will own a $25,000 car in just a few years caused the biggest sensation. But the more direct news is the announcement of a new cell type called 4680, which will be mass-produced in 2021. In fact, Tesla Giga Berlin has begun to build the world's largest battery factory, which will produce the 4680 cells. As Giga Berlin approaches the production of the so-called 4680 cells, the state of Brandenburg and the federal government are considering the amount of state assistance Tesla will receive for its battery innovation. According to the latest news from the local government, the state of Brandenburg and the federal government will reach an administrative agreement on the joint funding of Tesla's battery research and production in Giga Berlin. In addition, according to Tagesspiegel, as part of the European Union's Important Project for Common Interests in Europe program, Tesla can obtain €1.135 billion from the Federal Ministry of Economic Affairs and Energy for Giga Berlin's battery plant. However, the funding agreement is still in progress. Tesla is providing state assistance for its project called Clean and Cost-Effective Battery Assembly and Recycling. The project is in line with a plan in the Important Projects of European Common Interest. Earlier this year, Tesla received public funding from the IPCEI program called the European Battery Innovation Project. The Commission approved a European Battery Innovation program worth €2.9 billion, which focuses on research and innovation in the local battery value chain. If Tesla receives €1.135 billion in funding for the Giga Berlin battery factory, it will receive one-third of the total funding approved by the European Battery Innovation Project Commission. Outside Europe, a recent video from the Shanghai Gigafactory shows that with the end of the third quarter of 2021, Tesla China is ready to push the end of the quarter again. Drone operator Wu Hua recently released another video about Giga Shanghai, demonstrating the production strength of Tesla to the electric car community. The Chinese-made Model 3 and Model Y units in the video appear to be fully packed. As of September 3, Giga Shanghai seems to have reached the highest operating rate since full operation in 2020. Last year, Tesla produced a total of 509,737 vehicles and delivered 499,550 vehicles, which is a small part of the 2020 guidance target. At an annual production rate of 450,000 vehicles, the Chinese Gigafactory will be very close to the total number of vehicles produced by Tesla last year. Tesla has not formulated specific guidelines for 2021. However, the company did point out that it will exceed its record production and delivery figures in 2020. The Berlin Gigafactory was originally scheduled to start operations this year and was supposed to begin delivering Model Y in Europe this quarter. However, even without a factory in Germany, Tesla seems to be able to meet its 2021 guidelines through the Fremont factory and Shanghai Gigafactory. According to reports, Tesla Super Shanghai started producing 1,000 Model Y a day last month. Tesla China officially exported 8,210 Model Y to Europe in July, and the goods arrived in August. With only a few days left in August, Tesla began delivering Model Y in Europe. In less than a week, Tesla Model Y climbed to the top of the Norwegian sales charts, beating the Volkswagen ID.4 and Ford Mustang Mach-E and other electric vehicles. In the last earnings conference call, Shanghai Gigafactory was officially named as Tesla's main export hub. Based on the number of vehicles found in Tesla's parking lot in China, the Shanghai Gigafactory certainly lives up to the company's expectations, even more. Finally, if you are hesitant between Model Y and Model 3, you need to consider the following details before making the great leap forward. For those whose purchase of an electric car depends on their budget, the decision between these two Tesla cars may be simple. Model 3 is much cheaper than Model Y, mainly because Model 3 provides standard range plus configuration. The Model 3 standard range starts at approximately US$40,000. This is a single-motor rear-wheel drive vehicle with an EPA estimated cruising range of 262 miles. Model Y was briefly listed as standard range, and it seems that there are plans to launch cheaper models in the future. However, for now, the cheapest version is the dual-motor all-wheel drive long range, which starts at about $54,000. It is much more spacious than Model 3, and it also has 100 miles of EPA mileage, 326 miles. Except for some key details, Model 3 and Model Y are essentially the same car. So, the real question here is whether Model Y is worth the extra $14,000. As with any of these comparisons, the final decision depends on your budget and priorities. If you need a relatively cheap, sporty and powerful EV, Model 3 is a good choice. If you need a vehicle that is more suitable for family use, with enough passenger and cargo space, and optional third-row child size, Model Y is a better choice. We hope you enjoyed this video. Feel free to leave your comment in the section below, and please don't forget to like and subscribe and be sure to turn on the notification bell so you don't miss out on any of our new videos. There are many more future-focused tech videos coming soon, so until then stay tuned, and we'll see you in the next video.